Hi, this is Sam Guan with Siemens PLM Software. Today I'd like to share with you some of the new functionality that is coming out in the later release of our production release of NX11. In this case, I have a particular tail sections of aircraft. I see that I have two major sub-assembly that exists. What I want to do is just want to go in there and create a particular leading edge rib. We see that as we zoom in, this particular rib is already kind of have a starting point of that. So this bottom part of this particular leading edge rib, we want to make that design that has a somewhat similar features as the one above it. So in this case, as we see that we start that with the kind of a rectangular plate. So now I want to go ahead and just kind of drill down into the more of a detailed design of this particular geometry. So we see that we want to go ahead and link some of those information so we can use that in our design. Want to kind of grab onto the face of another geometry on the back end of that rib. So we want to grab onto the sidewall of that as well. So once that information is captured, I can go ahead and go into my detail design and then just utilize my advanced flange and just create that flange. Based on some of the surface that we already captured earlier and trimming that off, we see how quickly we can edit that and then and create that advanced flange on both sides. And this type of functionality is really simple and quick that we can create that those three flanges based on the geometry. Now, the one we're just creating now is using that link face that we just quickly added to our body. And then now we see that all three flanges are created. The next thing we want to do is just go ahead and hide some of those, kind of clean up our area a little bit so we can see what we're doing. What we want to do next is that we want to create a kind of a joggle. In this case, that the sidewall of that spar that we want to have this rib mounted to, we want to create that joggle from that advanced flange. So we'll go ahead and select some of the requirement and then just reverse the vector, and when we quickly we see that we could have a this kind of advanced joggle that is created into our the rib section on the tail end of that. And then once that is done, we can just get that more of a proper information. In this case, we know what is the distance, what that joggle needs to be, put that information in, and that is quickly created that joggle for me on the tail end of that. Likewise, we can do that on the other side as well. We could either do a mirror feature. In this case, might as well just create another joggle on the other side. So once that is done, and see how quickly we have created that that information of those flanges using the wavelength geometry. The next thing we'll want to do is we want to create what's called lightning holes. Lightning holes basically give us either through the axis of this particular rib or reduce some of the weight of this particular design. So we already have some sketch already created. Just by simply create, just by selecting this sketch curves, and then see that we punch those holes through using these parameters that I've previously selected. So now we see that how we can quickly add those lightning holes to that particular design as well. The next thing we'll want to do is just bring that back in the context of the assembly, and then we see that we have utilized the aerospace flange and then the joggles and the lightning holes to create this particular leading edge rib on the tail end of this aircraft. And that's how quickly we can get that done. And this concludes our demonstration. Thank you.